والصلاة والسلام على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين قدوة الصابرين المحتسبين وإمام المنيبين المخبتين وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. We praise Allah تبارك وتعالى. We thank Allah. Mighty belongs to Him and the kingdom of the heavens and the earth. The absolute power is in His hands. He is the conqueror, the supreme. We praise Him, we thank Him, in Him we seek help and forgiveness. We bear witness and we testify openly that no God worthy of worship but Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, He is alone without partner. And we bear witness and testify that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a servant and messenger of Allah. Peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, upon his family and his sahaba. We ask Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, the Almighty, to have mercy on At-Tabi'un, everyone who follow Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and his sahaba footsteps until the day of judgment. Also, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept our ibadat. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make the end of our struggle, the end of our suffering, the end of our test to be in Jannah. The road to Jannah is not an easy road. The road to Jannah is not an easy road. As Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, man khafa adlaja. Man khafa adlaja. Wa man adlaja balagha al-manzil. Ala inna sil'ata Allahi ghaliya. Ala inna sil'ata Allahi al-jannah. Man khafa adlaja. You know, the translation of this word means that the one who fear will walk in the darkness looking for Jannah. Whatever you have to do to get to Jannah, this is what you're going to do. And whoever walk in the darkness looking for Jannah, meaning that you struggle, you did your best looking for Jannah, you will find Jannah. Balagha al-manzil. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, ala inna sil'ata Allahi ghaliya. Allah, you know, commodity is very expensive. You know, Allah commodity is what? Jannah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us Jannah. And in the surah, in the salat, we recited, tilka al-jannah allati nurithu min ibadina man kana taqiyya. Such is the paradise which we will give as an inheritance to those of our servants who used to be pious. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those people, because Jannah is our goal. Jannah is our goal. And Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepare for the believers. أَعَدَّ اللَّهُ لِعِبَادِهِ مَا لَا عَيْنٌ رَأَتْ لِعِبَادِهِ الصَّالِحِينَ مَا لَا عَيْنٌ رَأَتْ. Allah has prepared for His righteous servants what no eye has seen, what no ear has heard, and what no human heart has conceived. So this is the place that we have to do our best to get there. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the highest level of energy and iman so that we can do our best to get to Jannah. As we mentioned, the road to Jannah is not an easy road. You know, from the hikmah, from the wisdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is that he made the road to Jannah filled with things that goes against human wishes and human inclination. And there are hadith talking about that. One of the hadith, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, حُجِبَتُ الْجَنَّةِ حُجِبَتِ الْجَنَّةِ بِالْمَكَارِهِ وَحُجِبَتِ النَّارِ بِالشَّهَوَاتِ. Another narration, حُفَّتِ الْجَنَّةِ بِالْمَكَارِهِ وَحُفَّتِ النَّارِ حُفَّتِ الْجَنَّةِ بِالْمَكَارِهِ وَحُفَّتِ النَّارِ بِالشَّهَوَاتِ. This is the nas of the hadith, right? Jannah is surrounded with hardships and adversities. Jannah is surrounded with hardships. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us so that we can get through. And hellfire is surrounded with temptation. Huffat al-Jannah bil makari wa huffat. It means that Jannah is surrounded with responsibilities. These hardships are the responsibilities. You know, Islamically we have taba and we have taklif. Taba and taklif. Taklif is the responsibilities. The taba is human inclinations. When it's time for Fajr or 30 minutes before Fajr, the human nature is telling you, stay right there. You can sleep another hour. You know, you can rest another hour. But a believer who understands, you know, the seriousness of his responsibility will wake up. So, you know, I have a responsibility. I have to go and fulfill my duty to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we have taklif and we have tawaf. So, Jannah is surrounded with takalif responsibilities. And those responsibilities are what? Hard, difficult. Difficult, very difficult. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it easy for all of us. That's why there is hadith collected by Imam al-Nasa'i and Tirmidhi and also Abu Dawud. From Abu Huraira, Allah's Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Jannah, he called Jibreel alayhi salam, say, idhab wanzur ilayha. Go look at Jannah and come back and tell me what you think about it. Go look at Jannah and come back and tell me what you think about it. Jibreel went and come back. Say to Allah, Rabbi wa izzati. لا يسمع بها أحد إلا دخلها. My Lord, I swear by your mind, no one will hear about this place except that he will do his best or her best to get in. But Allah surrounded Jannah after that with what? Hardships. They called Jibreel, go look at it, they come back and tell me what you think about it. Jibreel went and come back and said, Rabbi wa izzatuk, inni khashitu, an la yadkhulaha ahad. My Lord, I swear by your mighty, I'm afraid that no one will be able to get in. Same thing with hellfire. Allah called Jibreel, look at hellfire. When Jibreel went there, hellfire was eaten. Itself. The hellfire was Eden itself. Jibreel came back and said, Wa izzatik, la yasma'u biha ahadun illa wa lam yadkhulha. No one will hear about it except that he will flee, make sure that he won't get in. But after that, Allah surrounded hellfire with what? Shahawa. With desires, temptation. And then Jibreel went again and came. come back and say, I'm afraid that no one will be able to escape from this place. Huh? We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us Jannah and save us from hellfire. That's why our road to Jannah, your road to Jannah, you have to fight 4 or 5 battles. Jabhat, battle. You have to fight 4 or 5 battles. Number one, you have to fight against Shaytan. Shaytan is open enemy for all of us. Shaytan lakum adu. Inna Shaytan lakum adu. Shaytan is an open enemy. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save us from Shaytan and his tricks. Shaytan, the first battle that we have to fight is against Shaytan. And Shaytan, he said, قَالَ فَبِمَا أَغْوَيْتَنِي لَأَقْعُدَنَّ لَهُمْ صِرَاطَكَ الْمُسْتَقِيمَ ثُمَّ لَآتِيَنَّهُمْ مِنْ بَيْنِ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَمِنْ خَلْفِهِمْ وَعَنْ أَيْمَانِهِمْ وَعَنْ شَمَائِلِهِمْ وَلَا تَجِدُ أَكْثَرَهُمْ شَاكِرِينَ. Because you have, you know, led me astray. فَبِمَا أَغْوَيْتَنِي, because you have led me astray. لَأَقْعُدَنَّ لَهُمْ, I will sit in the straight path of your service waiting for them. And I will come to them from before them, from behind, from the right, from the left. The ulama, they give that, you know, explanation of this ayah, say before them, meaning the hereafter. The hereafter. Shaitan will come and say, there is no hereafter. This is the, you know, don't fool yourself. There is no day of resurrection. Allah will not raise you, you know, after death. If we become bones and dust, how are we going to come back to life again? Allah responded, قُلْ يُعِيِّ الَّذِي. The one who gave these bones life before, in the first place, is able to do it. قُلْ يُعِيِّ الَّذِي أَنْشَأَ أَوَّلَ مَرَّةٍ وَهُوَ بِكُلِّ خَلْقٍ عَلِيمٌ. He is all the way of every creation. Then the next ayah was it, الَّذِي جَعَلَ لَكُم مِّنَ الشَّجَرِ. The one who produces from the green tree, produces for you from the green tree fire. You know, when you were in the jungle, sometimes you use the green tree, you know, to create fire. The one who put fire in that green tree is able to bring these bones back to life again. Shaytan will come to you and say, no, there is no akhir. So, in daily ideas before them. وَمِنْ خَلْفِهِمْ dunya. Some of the scholars, they say, مِنْ أَيْدِيهِمْ dunya, وَمِنْ خَلْفِهِمْ the akhir. Will come and design dunya for you and say, man, this is the, you're not going to live twice, you know. You only live once, so you have to take advantage. And you're running behind dunya, running behind dunya. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide all of us and make easy for all of us. وَعَنْ أَيْمَانِهِمْ. Shaytan will come on the right side. The ulama say, right side, it means the good deeds. Every time you intend to do good, the shaytan says, oh, take your time, it's not time, you know. It's not time yet. You know, you want to give, shaytan says, oh, that's too much, you can, you know, give less than that. You want to get up and pray, shaytan says, oh, you're so tired, wait until tomorrow. Shaytan comes through good deeds, to take you away from the right path. Take you away from the right path. And ulama, rahimahumullah, mentioned that, you know, every road that we take to travel, you can speed sometimes, and sometimes you can slow down, except the road of taqwa. When it comes to the road of taqwa, the way of taqwa, there is no slow down. That's why one of the scholars mentioned, he said, إذا سبقت إلى شيء مهما سبقت إلى شيء فلا تسبقن إلى تقوى. People can rush, you know, and haste and compete to get different things. Well, if you want, you can rush with them. If you want, you can take time. Except when it comes to taqwa. When it comes to taqwa, people speed and racing, then do not let anyone beat you when it comes to race to taqwa. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us taqwa. And taqwa is the highest level of amal. Taqwa ni ayatul amal. As the tawheed. Tawheed, the oneness of Allah, is nihayatul ilm. Nihayatul ilm, tawheed, wa nihayatul amal, taqwa. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us taqwa. So shaitan will come on the right side through the good deeds. On the left side through bad deeds. You know? So that is Allah you know, holy contemplative for this small spell. You know, this is nothing. Through bad deeds, shaitan will come. This is the first jabha, the first battle that we have to fight against shaitan. The second battle is against our own souls. Against our own souls. And nafsul amara bisu. You know, the souls also inclined to evil all the time. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save us from the evil of our own souls. You know, in Ramadan, the hadith of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned that shayateen will be tied up, but the soul is still dead. And one of the scholars, وخالف النفس والشيطان وعصيهما. You know, make sure that you disobey shaytan and your own soul, because the soul is always calling you, you know, to that which is not good for you in your dunya and in your akhirah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save us from the, you know, evil of our own souls. This is the second battle that we have to fight. The third battle that we have to fight is against, you know, the environment. The environment that you're in. The close friends. The close friends. Because close friends could be also, you know, something. They could lead you to trouble. You know, we all remember the story of Uqbat ibn Abi Mu'ayt. Uqbat ibn Abi Mu'ayt was one of the people of Makkah. And Ubay ibn Abi Khalf, also a great people of, you know, city of Makkah before Islam. Uqbat ibn Abi Mu'ayt, he went and listened to Prophet Muhammad one day, and Allah touches his heart. Something happened to his heart, and he accepted Islam. But he was a close friend to Ubay ibn Abi Khalaf. When he went back, and Ubay ibn Abi Khalaf heard that his best friend went and listened to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and accepted his religion, he got angry with him. He said, "Wajhi bi wajhi ka haram, your faith to my faith. It's haram, I will not see you again. Until you stop sitting with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, stop listening to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam." Some seer books mention that he asked him to go back, speak on the face of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and insult him. And he accepted. He denounced Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed this ayah, وَيَوْمَ يَعَضُّ الظَّالِمُ عَلَى يَدَيْهِ. And he was killed in the Battle of Badr. He was caught and killed. Uqbat ibn Abi Mu'ayt. And Allah revealed this ayah, وَيَوْمَ يَعَضُّ الظَّالِمُ. The day when the wrongdoer will cry at his hand. يَقُولُ, he will say, لَيْتَنِي أَوْلُ لَيْتَنِي لَمْ أَتَّخِذْ فُلَانَ لَيْتَنِي اتَّخَذْتُ مَعَ الرَّسُولِ سَبِيلًا أَوْ that I had taken, you know, path with the messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that I have never taken so and so as my close friend. So our environment, our close friends can lead us to trouble. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us so that we can be able to fight against that also. So when we fight against shaitan, fight against our souls, fight against our environment, the evil of our environment, and we still have to fight again. We still have to fight, you know, our intentions. You know, shahwatul khafi. Sometimes we do good deeds, but behind the good deeds is something is hidden. Right? You know, you pray to be seen, you give to be seen. Huh? You do good deeds for people to praise and talk about it. You recite the Quran so people can say it's a reciter. Huh? You seek the knowledge so people can say you are a knowledgeable person. All these is, they are the first people to enter hellfire. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save us. A person who went to jihad so that he can be called a hero. Or you seek knowledge so people can talk good about you. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save us. There is hadith. You know, ulama mentioned that this is hadith. This hadith is da'if, weak hadith, but they say the meaning is very good and the meaning of the hadith is important. Prophet Rasulullah mentioned that أخوف ما أتخوف عليكم, you know, الإشراك بالله. The thing that I'm afraid for my ummah is shirk. Then he said, أما إني لا أقول تعبدون صنما ولا شمسا ولا قمرا ولا وثنا ولكن أعمالا لغير الله. When people start doing the actions of worship, but for something other than Allah. For something other than Allah. أعمالا لغير الله والشهوة الخفية. You do everything and behind something hidden. You know. When we fight against that, ulama used to fight so that their intentions, their niyyah can be pure. And they look at that as the first, before anything. When we fight against that, we still have to fight. You know, sometimes we do good and we use that, you know, to gain power. You know, because I did this to you, now you have to listen to me. Because I did this, now you can't. You know, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تُبْطِلُوا صَدَقَاتِكُمْ بِالْمَنِّ وَالْأَذَى. We have to fight all these. All these are different battles that we have to fight until we get to Jannah. At the end of the day, no one will enter Jannah except through the rahmah of Allah. As Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, that your actions, your good actions, will not get you there. Because if all your good deeds, if Allah take all your good deeds for 6 years or 7 years or 8 years, just to pay the ni'mah of your eye, then you have nothing left. You have nothing left. So we're going to fight and fight. At the end, we have to go make sujood and ask Allah to cover us with His mercy. The Prophet Muhammad mentioned, no one will enter Jannah. Yes, you know, by your actions. إِلَّا أَنْ يَتَغَمَّدَ لِيَ اللَّهِ. Till Allah cover us with His mercy. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to cover us with His mercy. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to cover us with His mercy. You know, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make the road to Jannah for easy for all of us. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make the end of our struggle, the end of our suffering, to be in Jannah, you know, and dhikr, every time we remember to make dhikr, you know, certain dhikr is very important. There is hadith that Prophet Muhammad mentioned, after salah, if you say ayatul kursi, there is no a barrier between you and Jannah except what? Except death. So these things are very, very important for us, that we try to keep our tongue with remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to strengthen our iman. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us, you know, the steadfastness in this deen. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept our ibadah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us so that we can pass all these tests that are in front of us, you know, before death comes. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to purify our intentions. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help our children so that they can join the truth, you know, so they can and follow the right path. You know, one ayah in Surah Tur, Allah said, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَاتَّبَعَتُمْ ذُرِّيَّتُهُمْ بِإِيمَانٍ. You know, this is the mercy of Allah. Those who believe and their dhurriya, offspring, follow them in faith, Allah will raise the children to the rank of their fathers. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to raise our children the same way. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept our ibadat, give us good in this life, good in the hereafter. عباد الله من اللهم امركم بامر البدء في بنفسه فما بعدكم على ذلك فقال تعالى ان الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا ايها الذين امنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك اشهد ان لا اله الا انت استغفرك واتوب اليك والسلام عليكم ورحمه الله تعالى وبركاته.
ان شاء الله شيخ عبد العزيز is with us every Sunday. Every time I listen to him, it is you know, an opportunity for our minds to be uplifted. So please.